Yo, YBH.
What's up, guys? It's Eddie the Barber again. So something about myself, I've been cutting hair for 10 years. I've had 3 barber shops my entire life, and then I decided to go mobile. I went mobile because after I sold my last shop, I went to go work at my friend's shop in Encino, and it was far from my clients. Long story short, I lost all my clientele. That's when I realized that I had to figure out how to make it work, you know? And I realized that I didn't want to be in one place. I wanted to be free. Didn't want my clients to say that I was too far when the solution was I come to you. That's what gave me the idea to go mobile. This is the future, you know? Who wants to go to a barbershop nowadays? You know, you want your privacy, you want to be home. And I sell more than a cut. I sell time, you know? I give back time to my clients. The kind of clients that I target is mainly lawyers, doctors, business owners, people that don't have time to go sit 1 hour, 2 hours at the barbershop. Time is of essence for these people. I have kid clients that the parents don't have to worry about going to the shop. I come to the house, I cut the kids' hair, and it's like the parents didn't even notice the kids got a haircut. They didn't get in between their time, their office time, their work time, their personal time. The reason why I went for a Mercedes is because, like, you know, like my guys at Mercedes say, is the best or nothing, you know? If you want to do something, you got to do it right. I could have gone Ford, I could have gone Dodge, but it's like, nah, I wanted to target people that like luxury stuff. Mercedes is the way to do it. Come on, you know, VIP cuts. If I wanted to be VIP, I had to be VIP 100%. My goals for this YouTube channel is, to be honest with you, not even to get like viral or nothing. I'm just, you know, having fun with it. Why not? You know, I have such a great concept. I was one of the first barbers, mobile barbers in LA. I was a barber instructor at WBI last year. And it kind of inspired me to kind of help young barbers. If you want to start a mobile barbershop, you know, like, hit me up. You know, I'll do a video. I'll show you guys how to become a mobile barber. I'll show you why it's better and why you should be mobile instead of renting a location. It's the future, like I said before. Pros are, you're mobile, first of all. You're free. You get to be wherever you want, right? And no client will ever tell you that you're too far. Because why? Because you can pull up to their doorstep. You're never going to own the location you rent. So, I mean, as most of us out here want to be independent and want to be successful, you know that the number one thing is real estate. And to be honest with you, so people renting our locations for barbershops, they're never going to sell to us. So this is what I call mobile real estate. No one can kick you out of here. You're mobile, you go park wherever you want, and it's yours. And then you get another one, and it's, like I said, mobile real estate. You get better income, you get better clients, and you own yourself at the end of the day. But enough about that. Let me show you guys the mobile barbershop.
I've been confused as of late.
Yeah.
Watching my youth slip away.
Yeah.
You don't like the sun. You wake me up, but you drain me out if I eat too much. I might leave the room or I'll break.
So as you can see, step in here, you know, this is luxury at its finest. We got everything custom, everything designed out to my liking, to what I think high-end people think, you know. Over here at Premier, VIP, high-end, everything, no shortcuts. We got the AC unit, you know, we installed the AC unit heater system on it. We got a TV, we got whiskey, we got an espresso, you know, for the clients that I go in the morning, you know, they need a shot of fucking caffeine, wake them right up, yeah, right before the cut, you know. Then we got tequila for those day drinkers, which is, I don't really have a lot, but after work, you know.
Some people prefer that in the morning instead.
Some people prefer this in the morning instead. I got an eye vac, you know, to vacuum the hair in so I don't store it out. This is the best part right here, the Rolls Royce headliner. For me, this is it. It's like, nothing says more high-end than a Rolls Royce. And I just needed to have a piece of that in my barbershop. Especially the suede, it's not any suede, it's Alcantara. I mean, if you know McLaren, you know that's the kind of material they got in there. We got the crown molding in here, cold rack, you know, speakers, Alpine surround sound. We got a sink too, you know, we got hot water, cold water, customly built into this van. I mean, what else do you need in here? No, the chair, you can't get this chair off, you know, a regular barber store. I had to look hard for it. We got a PS4 hot towel warmer. The mirror is custom made. As you can see, we got the gray floor, we got the wood floor. Here at Premier, I didn't want to cut no expense. I invested everything. I didn't cheap out. I wanted everything good. I didn't want to cut no corners. This is the result of that. Somebody walks in here, they know what kind of service they're getting. Black and white, you know, that's that, you know, that's that like luxurious style to it. You got the white light,
not those
orange. Orange lights, red lights. So getting into detail into this custom bar, I could have just gone all black, you know, but I chose to go with some lights in it, you know, to exfoliate the bar and show the, you know, show the bar. Another good thing about this, you know, mobile barbershop, this is a tax write-off. Part of this, guys, that this van is a tax write-off. So your payment is a tax write-off. You can write this off $30,000 a year. That's huge. Another thing too, man, I'm going to show you guys right now, but it's a big-ass billboard driving around everywhere. Anywhere you drive with this thing, it's a billboard. You got your number out there. They're going to call you. People are going to ask what you do, and then it's free marketing.
I mean, I get to own it in the end too.
And you get to own it at the end, man. You never, like I said earlier, you're never going to own the location where you have a barbershop. You're not. This is the next big thing. Mobile real estate. You're going to own this. Let's say you pay it off, right? Let's say you pay it off. You're done. You profited already. You sell this thing and give it to someone else, and you still make profit on when you sell this thing. These things keep their value. All right, you guys. So, you know, this is it. Stay tuned for the next video. We're going to do more. We're going to do weekly content. Hope you guys like my story. Maybe, you know, I can help you with yours, and maybe, like, you can learn something off my story and not make mistakes that I've made. So stay tuned. And I'm going to put this Perrier down, and I'm going to head to the beach and give me some tequila, because this is what free barbers do. So free at the beach. So stay tuned, guys.